like before, I have the sum of this mixer out to my care in and out. Maybe show a photo. Maybe not, I don't really care. I don't know how to use this, so I wanted to give it a shot. So it is the ADAC system 4-voice cluster, which could be very cool. Let's take the Lopez out. Go in. We got a little volume. But I hear nothing, because I think we have 4 triggers. Cutoff CV, external in, and then the 3. Okay. I don't know what these switches do. Anyways, so I've got an LFO over here on the left. It's Diff Kids. I'm a big fan of it. I think it's cool. I don't use a lot of LFO, though, to be honest. Maybe it has to be an out. Understanding, we have frequency, we get decay. What the hell is this? FM. Okay, so these can adjust for others. 4 triggers, low, band, high. Looks like the cutoff, we can, oh, you know what, let's do that. Let's take the cutoff and just put it on this low LFO. So this is now adjusting this. Still don't have a pulse going on, so let's turn that mic down, and then we'll take the clock here. Then we'll put in the clock here. So we have a Turing machine. Each of these red dots should send a pulse. That pulse is triggering this voice, but we have some other options here. So on the side here, I have a Turing pulses, and so what we could do, we can send that to trigger 2. Thank you. So, 3. Interesting that it stays on. That's what pulses is doing. When the pulse is high, put it in band. Well, shocking. It's in band pass. What if we put it in high? What do you think's gonna happen? Okay. But I don't really know what these things do. Speed up everything else, right? External in is significantly higher volume. So what I would have to do to make that even reasonable, let's stick it in here, which will currently we can cut that out. Normalization. So then we can put that trigger back in. Thank you. take one of the clocks. This is cool. This is weird.